genuine in what they're doing.
Yeah.
They got a job and they're happy with it. They want to keep it going.
That's sad.
But you want to say, have I ever lost a night's sleep over the decision, the commutation decision? No.
Yeah.
I've never. I'm glad I did it. I'd do it again in a heartbeat. It took me a while to get to that point, but I've never had any regrets about it. The only regret that I have is that I executed the guy. This whole process, that's my big regret.
Oh, okay. Wikipedia describes you as having raised a national debate on capital punishment. What remains to be done on the fight against it?
Well, I think you have to keep, this is an educational process. The whole thing is, it's like anything where you got a cause. Now, people are so ingrained, like me, like I was. You're raised with the death penalty. You knew it was right because the government's never made any mistakes, and they went after people, and they executed them because they were horrendous people, and they had it coming. And that's kind of an inbred thing in our society. It has been for years. And so to change it, people have to be educated. And the reason I changed was because I learned some things about it that I never knew or understood or bothered to find out about. And people today are very busy in their everyday lives, and they pick up the paper and they say, Joe Blow is, got executed. He probably had it coming, and that's good. And I was one of those guys, basically, that did that. So, well, it's a part of the system, and we need to have it. And it probably deters crime to some degree. That's what I thought.
Yeah.
So until I got into it and I got to looking at it, and we had all these people that were on death row that sat there for 20 years in a system of checks and balances that didn't check or balance anything. And then to find out that they're innocent and didn't do the crime and sat on death row, the checks and balances just didn't work because nobody would make the decision. Part of the problem in the world today is political correctness. There's too much of that. We got to be more concerned about what's right, not politically right, but what's correct, period. And for somebody to sit on death row as an innocent man or woman, mostly men, for 20 years is just crazy in this system, in our system. There ought to be somebody that can come in and say, we've checked this thing out and we can't prove it, like they eventually did. When we ended up with 13 out of 25 being exonerated, they were on death row. It's like flipping a coin. So it's one of those situations that we just have to, people like you and that are in your movement and young people like you, that are going to have to deliver this message. I think eventually the United States will come to their senses and realize what the situation is and how we look as a society because we favor the death penalty and are eager to kill and look for states to execute the teenagers in and minors because we're a little bloodthirsty. And that whole thing will eventually turn around because of young people like you. So you just got to keep the faith and keep up the cause and keep working hard to get it done. That's why I'm coming up to talk to your young people. So what did you think my one accomplishment was? Death penalty?
Yeah.
Well, look, that was, we haven't really accomplished much there.
I know.
That's the problem with that.
I actually Thoreau's book, Ultimate Punishment, where he lists out all the reforms that your committee.
Right.
What do you think is going to happen with that? Because I know Blagojevich is just like saying, I'm not going to bring back the death penalty until things are fixed or until I can, assure myself that it's right. But I've never heard about them actually implementing any of.
Well, they did. Some of them. They passed into law. See, that's why I did what I did. That's why I commuted those sentences because I couldn't get any action out of the General Assembly. The commission went to work, spent hours and days and months putting out this report with 85 recommendations for legislative change. Democrat-controlled House managed to pass out a few of them that they sent over to the Senate. But it was an election year. Nobody wanted to be caught somebody thinking they were soft on crime by making some reforms in the death penalty system. So they just were sent over to the Republican-controlled Senate, where they were just absolutely killed. I mean, they got stuck in a committee, and nobody ever heard of them again. I was running out of time as being for the governor, and decided that if I was going to do anything, I had to make up my mind and do it. So that's why I waited till about 3 days before I left the office to commute the sentences. And I did everything I could to get the General Assembly to move those bills, but they just wouldn't do it because it was a, an election year. So some of those things have been changed. I think single eyewitnesses can no longer put somebody on death row. And, I think jailhouse snitches are controlled a little different. Videotaping is a process now that we're using that we didn't use before. It was a recommendation. But for the most part, those recommendations are still just kind of hanging around the assembly. There's only one fellow that I know of in the General Assembly, and that's my friend Emile Jones, who's the president of the Senate now. When I was there, when I was governor, he was the minority leader of the Senate. But Emile Jones is a true advocate and a believer of what we did, and was probably my biggest ally while I was in the House. He's a Democrat. He's now the president of the Senate, and after he got to be president of the Senate, he got some of these things implemented and passed. Because we had to clout to do it. Now, you know what he did with this in the Carrico case? He took this guy Dugan. You know about Dugan?
Yeah, Dugan's a serial killer, right? That was like the guy to the crime.
I'll confess, I did the Carrico case all by myself. Nobody else did it. I did it.
Yeah.
And I will sign a confession that says I did it if you don't prosecute me for the death penalty.
He wouldn't take it, right?
And they wouldn't take the deal. Now Burkett comes to the chance to be lieutenant governor, and he files a suit against Dugan for the Carrico case and charges him under the death penalty statute. I don't know where that case is, but he did it only because he was a candidate and wanted to get the publicity on it. I mean, it was strictly a political move. Dugan's been sitting in jail for a long time and will be there the rest of his life. And Burkett files, they could have just had the guy confess, close the case, to save a lot of money. But he decided he wanted to use him to show how strong he was for the death penalty.
What do you think will happen in the next, with the death penalty and the reforms? Do you see it?
Well, let me tell you, I think, you know, we were making some progress in the death penalty stuff. And not only, I think, even before I did what I did, and then I helped it some. And then along comes this terrorist stuff. And I think that's built up some more support for the death penalty. People say there are reasons for the death penalty, and if somebody can fly an airplane into a building and do whatever they do, the people that are responsible for that ought to be killed. And so there is a lot of support that I think that we had started to put down and started to come back up for the death penalty. I haven't seen any numbers on it.
Do you have any last remarks, like a last sentence that you want to put out there?
No, I just think that it's going to take young people like you to continue in this movement to get a change. It doesn't come easy, and it won't come easy. And it's going to take a different mindset than people my age, I think, that have been raised and taught the way we were taught. I think young people today have a different idea about it.